G'day, welcome to Monash Nova Rover. We're a student team based at Monash University in Melbourne, Australia, comprised of 60 students from engineering, science, IT, design and commerce backgrounds. This year, we've completely redesigned our chassis body to improve accessibility and minimise weight. At only 36 kilos, it provides rapid access to critical systems and can alternate between arm and science payloads within 10 minutes. Our novel double bogey suspension features an interchangeable differential bar, providing stability on any incline with any payload. In-house designed and fabricated CAN bus motor drivers operate the wheels and arm joints with a modular design and high current capacity. The new distribution board contains 6 motor drivers, condensing the drive system while allowing for in-situ repairing diagnostics. An updated 8-cell LifePro battery unit monitors cell voltages, current and temperature with an improved safety shutdown switch. A new GUI features a cluster of G-Streamer video feeds which can be changed on the fly, providing the operator with critical information from the rover. 5.8 GHz and 900 MHz radios provide large bandwidth and lossless control, enabling reliable connection over obstacles and to distances of 1 kilometre.
To overcome the difficult terrain in extreme retrieval, the chassis team has redesigned the drive system. Our flexible, custom 3D printed wheels improve traction and dampening. As a single component, they reduce complexity, are lightweight, and are quickly interchangeable. In 2019, the gearboxes were an area of weakness, and so this year we've upgraded to stronger and more reliable Vex Pro models. We've developed a new gimbal camera, allowing for improved and complete control over our field of view, supporting the rapid identification and tracking of objects during competition tasks. New custom cycloidal gearboxes, driven by the high-powered Maxon motors, now enable the robotic arm to have very low backlash and high gear reduction in a small and lightweight package. The new gearboxes provide full rotary range of motion at each joint, granting longer reach and easier manipulation of objects. The rotary joints allow the arm to be safely stowed, increasing the stability of the rover when carrying heavy loads between task checkpoints in uneven terrain.
To achieve the precision and dexterity required for the equipment servicing task, our new tubular arm structure provides excellent rigidity in all directions, while our custom cycloidal gearboxes provide a stable platform for precise control of the end effector. Each joint's motor includes a high-resolution quadrature encoder, allowing high-accuracy velocity control. 14-bit resolvers on all joints provide reliable position data without needing a homing procedure. Together, they allow the operator to control the arm velocity in Cartesian space using inverse kinematics, simplifying control during linear movements such as opening drawers. We've constructed a full-scale replica of the 2019 equipment servicing rocket, enabling accurate assessments of arm performance and realistic simulated operator training. The two-finger equipment servicing end effector allows for the manipulation of objects of various geometries, facilitating interaction with switches and joysticks. The wide opening of the jaw can also grasp large objects, such as the cache container directly.
To improve on our previous pitfalls in the autonomous task, we're using the gazebo simulator to test our algorithms before deploying them onboard our primary computer, the NVIDIA Jetson TX2, built for advanced graphical processing. The rover first applies an extended Kalman filter to fuse data from onboard odometry data, GPS and IMU sensors, greatly improving the accuracy of rover positioning. A 360-degree LiDAR then generates a point cloud, which is fed into FastLAM2, an algorithm which simultaneously provides high-accuracy localization and mapping of the rover and surrounding features. The A-star pathfinding algorithm then finds an efficient path to the checkpoint and also navigates around obstacles. Finally, the detection of AR tags will be done with a stereo camera, supporting the identification of markers and gates. To notify judges' completion of task stages, an LED strip has been integrated to the rear of the rover.
The 2020 scientific payload, Joey, is capable of acquiring up to 4 unique samples during the science task. Several positioning sensors allow fine control over the volume of regolith collected. An independently actuating microscope with dynamic control of exposure, brightness, and focal length will also allow high-resolution imaging. Once samples are acquired, 2 biochemical assays and a purpose-built photospectrometer will perform in-situ life detection.
Proteins and enzyme activity will be investigated, allowing the team to determine the presence of life in samples and distinguish between extinct and extant. Joey will also monitor a range of environmental variables, further supporting habitability investigations. Geological analysis is enabled by images from the microscope, which will allow grain size and shape of rock and soil to be identified, even in varying test conditions. Finally, a mineralogical database has been integrated into the rover's GUI to streamline this process.